In this illustration, we'll demonstrate you how to calculate the equivalent resistance of an infinite grid. Here, the figure shows an infinite wire grid with the square cells, and the resistance of each wire between neighboring junctions is R. And here we are required to find the equivalent resistance of the grid across these two points A and B. And the resistance of each wire here is R. In this situation, we solve this problem by using principle of superposition, where you can see if we connect a battery between terminal A and it is grounded like this, say this is a battery of voltage V and it is connected to ground. And say if we consider B terminal to be open, then due to symmetry, in every branch connected to A, all these four branches, the current will be equally divided because here we are assuming B is to be kept open. So, if a current I is getting into terminal A, it will be divided as I by 4, I by 4 and so on in all four branches. So, we can say here if I current enters at A, then current flowing through the branch AB will be I by 4. This by symmetry if B is kept open. And if in another case, we keep this A open and we connect this battery B with the battery in opposite polarity with low potential terminal at B and high potential is grounded. And we keep A open. Then here you can see again the same amount of current I which was flowing and getting into A will be withdrawn from point B through the battery because battery is same and the grid is also symmetric. Then again we can see if I current leaves at B, then by symmetry we can see from point B in all four branches I by 4, I by 4 will be contributed and this current I is constituted. So here again IAB is equals to I by 4. So here if both of these situations are superposed, then we can say if a current I is getting at point A and I is leaving at B, then simultaneously if a battery of voltage V is connected between the two, again a current I flows, but the current in the wire AB will be I by 2. So if both the situations are superposed and a battery of EMF V is connected across A and B, the current through wire AB is, in this situation, the current through wire AB will be I by 4 plus I by 4, that is equals to I by 2. So, if the current I is distributed in such a way that in wire AB a current I by 2 is flowing, that means through rest of the grid also the current flowing is I by 2. So, here in this situation we can write the resistance of whole grid across terminals R, A and B can be written as resistance of terminals A and B in parallel combination with the same resistance R because current between AB and remaining grid is equally divided. So, rest of the grid will also have a resistance equal to that of the wire AB. Then only we can say that current is half supplied through wire AB and remaining half through the rest of the grid. So, it will be equals to R by 2. That will be the final result of this problem.